Hey everybody, Barb from the Shabby Tree. Guess what? We are here to do a live craft on YouTube. Now listen, if you're part of my channel, I want to thank you for being part of the Shabby Tree and following us over here on YouTube. I did a craft this morning on Facebook and I did a live craft on Instagram today. So I thought, why not? Let's jump on YouTube. Now, I am going to tell you what we're making. Part of it we made a week ago and part of it we made this morning. We're going to combine, mix everything up and make something totally different. I'm not even sure. I was waiting to see. Hey, there we go. Hey, Trucy Petty. Trucy Petty, how are you, girl? Trucy Petty, would you PM me your address over on Facebook and I will send you something in the mail. You know how it works. It's no different than Facebook. I am still going to do my appreciation gifts. Hey, Donna. Okay, just a little different. You're a little bit further away, but it's all okay. Okay, so what we're here to do is, do you guys know how you loved that pitcher made out of the recycled can? Okay, we're going to change it up a little bit. We're going to do something different. I just kind of want to hang out. A lot of people that follow on YouTube do not follow on Facebook, so that's why I'm here. So, hey, Suzanne, everybody. I hope you're all having a great Wednesday. Okay, this is a recycled can good. Yes, it's a green bean one. I know that a lot of us don't buy green beans in this big of a can. You can ask your church if they will save some cans for you when they do the food drives, anything like that. You can ask the school lunch, but school's out right now, so you can ask the school cafeterias to save some cans. You just need, and this does not even have to be made as a large can, guys. You can use a small can. Now, this is live, so we're gonna see if I can actually crush this can live. I did this on a blog post. The can is not easy to crush, but we're gonna see what happens. You never know what happens on a live. You guys all know that. Hey, Debbie Stroll, how are you, girl? Okay, so we got our recycled can right here. Now, what we're gonna do is you want to form this can into a pitcher. We are making like a farmhouse pitcher, and I mean a pitcher like to put water in, pour water into your flowers, or just a decorative pitcher to add some fresh flowers into, anything like that. Now, there's no rhyme or reason to this. You just squish your can where you want, but what I'm looking at is there's like a line back here, so I think I'm gonna have this be the back and this be the front. Now, the first thing first is, let's see, I'm trying to read some names. Hey, Lynette, hey, Paula, hey, Whitney. Okay, so you're gonna need a hard surface to push down your can. So what you're gonna do is you are going to squeeze, you're gonna squeeze your can, okay? It's very easy. You would never think that, now I don't want this side squeezed though. You would never think that you can squeeze this. I would have never thought I could squeeze this, okay? So let's see who's on here. Hey, Beth, hey, Jackie. So, do you see how it's coming to a point? You see that? It's kind of what I said when we did this on Facebook. It kind of looked like a bird's beak to me a little bit. Okay, let's just squeeze a little bit more. Don't push on this side like I originally was. So, hey, Paula, how are you, girl? All right, so now let's pull this out. All right, so you've got, I think I got the point as much as I want it. Now, you see it? You getting a good look of it? Okay, now what I did was I came over and about like 2 inches up from the main little point I created here, I took my fingers and I push it in a little bit. It helps give this back end a little bit more roundness. So let's see. All I'm gonna do is come in and I'm going to push. Haha, we say we're gonna push. We're gonna see. Hey, Avery. Oh, wait a minute. Avery. I was thinking it was Avery, but it is Jackie. Jackie Camden, how are you? Jackie, I'm freezing up on you. I am so sorry, girl. All right, Jackie, I got to punch this in just like this, and we're gonna go on to this side. Okay, are you seeing what it's doing? Are you seeing how I'm pushing in right here and it's kind of given this to come out a little bit? That's the look I'm trying to achieve, if you can see it. So this one's pushed in good. I just need to get this one pushed in just a little bit more. All right, are you seeing that? Okay, now that's the shape of your can, just like this. You're gonna play around, you're gonna push in, push out wherever you have to. So let's see, Jackie, the can bends so easy. Now, here's where the magic happens at the Shabby Tree. It needs to be, we're doing a little different. Okay, you want me to show you what we're, okay. This is what we made on Facebook like 2 weeks ago. This can turns into this. Now, we're changing it up a little bit. We're not Mod Podging tonight, okay? We're changing it up. So This is napkins I got from Home Goods. We decoupaged them onto the can. I sprayed the can inside and outside with warm caramel spray paint. I put a little handle on and it's stinking beautiful, is it not? Okay, I wanna change it up. So what I did was I went outside and I sprayed the can again with warm caramel because I don't know why I seem to be obsessed with warm caramel lately. Hey, Teresa Peterson, thank you for those hearts, girl. So I sprayed the can with warm caramel. Then on the outside, I used the Heirloom White. Now, I was hoping, I forgot to bring my little sanding sponge. I was going to use the sanding sponge on it, but I didn't bring it, but it's all okay. I was gonna sand some of it off and give it a really good rustic look, but I left my sanding sponge. So this is what we've got going on so far, just like this. Now, I pre-drilled my holes right here. I went outside just a minute ago and I drilled two holes because what I wanna do is I wanna add the handle. Now I got a different handle here and I'm looking for my little bolt. Okay, this handle came from Hobby Lobby. Guys, you see that handle? Look how rustic it looks, right? Now it's greens and it's browns and I think I made you guys disappear. Hey Whitney, how are you? Girl, thank you for jumping on. All I did was take a marker and I marked where my two holes needed to be drilled. And you're going to shove your hand. Guys, come on. Look at that stinking thing. Now this little handle turns in and out, but I love the look of it. Do you see it? I'm so bummed I left my sanding sponge down in the other part. Now, I lost one of my little bolts outside when I was spray painting. So we only have one to put on right now, but it'll be okay. It'll hold it. Later on, I'll go outside and find that other one that rolled away on me, okay? This will do for right now. Okay, then you have your handle. My goodness, do you see how stinking cute that is? You all gotta give this a try. It's way too easy, way too easy. Teresa, this is way too easy. Now, here's where I'm gonna incorporate what we've done this morning, okay? So on Facebook and Instagram, we made flowers out of cheesecloth. Now, are you seeing where I'm going here? Okay, are you seeing the color scheme all blending in together? I want just a very rustic little looking farmhouse pitcher. I think it's gonna turn out cute. So let's see, who's on here, everybody? Thanks for joining me. Okay, I already pre-cut my strips so we don't be on here long. You guys can catch the videos also step by step of everything of me making these flowers twice today already, once on Facebook, once on Instagram, and now YouTube. Why not, right? So let's see. Hey, pine tree. Does that say pine tree? What kind of can? Hey, it is, mine was just a recycled green bean can. Green beans were in this. It came from a church kitchen. So mine was green beans. So any kind of can. It doesn't even have to be a big one, guys. You can do the same thing with smaller ones because I've seen my followers doing it on Crafting with the Shabby Tree. Okay, now all I'm doing, this is on the blog also, how to make these step by step. You can do this with material too. I'm just loving the cheesecloth. So my cheesecloth is from Walmart and I coffee stained it. So that's why it's got this little grungy, do you see it? Coffee stain and instant coffee. That's on the blog too. So can you use a coffee can? Yes, if you have a metal coffee can. Now, I will tell you, my coffee cans that I buy are not metal. They're like a paper coffee can. So I'm not sure. If you have a metal coffee can, yes, any can. I just think you want metal. You want something that's like, I don't know, what is this? This is a tin can, a aluminum can. What is the cans made out of? Is it aluminum? It's just a recycled green bean can is what I'm using. So any type of can you've got. Now, let's see. I went out and came back in still freezing. Girl, I don't know, Jackie. What is she doing? Am I working? Hey, am I working now? What happened? Guys, I froze. I froze. I got a phone call and it froze me up. Look, we'll see if I... Dang, I'm freezing. I froze too, girl. Okay, so hey, Donna Scipio, the cheesecloth. Absolutely stinking amazing. Kimberly, there I am. Kimberly, what happened? Did it work or did I leave or what happened? Hey, guys, tell me what happened there for a minute. My mother-in-law tried to FaceTime me. I have no idea. I hope I'm buffering. What the heck does that mean? Okay, let's just go with it. We'll see what happens here. Okay. Now, this is all we're gonna do. We're gonna quickly make a flower, okay? So I'm using cheesecloth. I cut a strip. I don't even know how wide. Normally my strip I did today was 20 inches long and I kinda wanna make it like an inch I want to kind of make it like an inch wide, but you're just going to go with it. You're going to figure it out. Thank you, Sandra. I'm better now. I hope my mother-in-law don't try to call me again. I did not hit my do not disturb, so if she tries calling me again, it might not work. Okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to just start to roll it, and you're going to roll it just like this. And I know you guys have seen this already today if you caught me on Facebook, but you're going to start to roll it just like that. You see it? Quick, simple, easy. Now, the trick is you want to start, I'm adding just a dab of hot glue. I didn't add hot glue today until the very end, but I am going to add a dab of hot glue right now. Now, you want to keep your flour the same thickness all the way around, just like this. You don't want to start coming up and you don't want to start going out this way. You want it to stay flat and the same thickness. So, Jackie, no, my limelines have not started to bloom yet. I'm a little worried about them. Okay, so how many have not hit the like button? Oh gosh, I don't know. What the heck does that mean? How many have not? Guys, make sure you like, follow, and comment and subscribe, whatever the heck it is. Okay, so Angela, all these little things are killing me. I'm getting the hang. I'm starting to learn Instagram, but now I gotta learn YouTube. Okay, the trick here is twist. You gotta twist, guys. So when you keep coming around, twist just like this. Do you see it? Guys, it's so stinking easy. This is so easy. So do you see how I'm twisting? So just keep coming around and just keep twisting. Oh my gosh, this guy's now. See, that's why you wanna make sure that you add a little hot glue. Okay, look, we're gonna twist and we are going to twist. I'm gonna add some more glue right now just in case that happens again. Okay, so let me come here. We're gonna add just a little dab of hot glue. Don't go crazy with the hot glue. Just add a little bit of hot glue. Okay, man, I've been making flowers all day long, whipping these out. So, hey, Jackie Camden. Okay, Jackie, thanks for sticking with me. Okay, so this is what, Suzanne, the flowers are so stinking easy. I guess I'm a little obsessed with them today, right? Because I've been making them on on everything I have. I made them on YouTube. I'm making them on Instagram. I'm making them on Facebook. Okay, now here's what we're going to do. We're just going to keep coming around. Do you see it? Guys, are you seeing how pretty it is? Now, today, I made them also, I didn't bring it, I made them in a mustard color, kind of like a mustard gold yellow. Okay, Sandra, you see me twice today. Sandra, this should be your third time. Sandra, I was live on Facebook, live on Instagram, and now I'm live on YouTube. This should be your third time, girl. Which one did you miss? Okay, so here's what it's looking like, guys, just like this. All right, now, depending on how long your strip of fabric is how big your flower is gonna be. So if you want your flower just this big right here, cut this off now and let it go. Now, what I am going to show you right now is, guys, all right, I have a little bit of bling right here, but if you want to make brooches, look, I can slice this all up. This could be like all little ribbons. You could put your pin on the back and it would be a quick, simple. Are you seeing how easy this is? You could create a brooch so easily, but I want this for the can. Now, we're going to have three of them. I already have two made, so don't freak out. I'm not going to sit here and make this forever, okay? So, this is the first one for me. Girl, where were you all day with your grandkids? Okay, I'm so glad you're catching me on here. And thank you for following me on YouTube. All right, so let's give some more quick twists. I want this one a little bit bigger. I was trying to make two bigger and one smaller. We'll see what we got going on. So, let me hurry up and end this flower. The only thing I'm going to tell you, the important part of this is to make sure you twist, because that's what's giving you that cute little flower look right there. So I'm going to give this a try. Please do. You're going to love it. It's so easy. There's not one of you on here that cannot make this. Now, you should do this too, because this is stinking easy. This is very easy. I'm telling you. Hey, Jackie, I am having the best day. I hope you're having the best day too. Jackie's wishing you all an amazing day. Guys, it's Wednesday. Tomorrow's Thursday, just so you didn't know that, I thought I would tell you. So, Jackie says she's made these flowers. Jackie, what color and what did you use? Did you use cheesecloth? So, hey, Brenda Burns, how are you, girl? Thank you for joining me on YouTube. Okay, here's what we got going on. You see how stinking amazing it is? Now, when you come to the end, it's not complicated. Just glue your end down just like this. You're never even going to see that it's the end. I'm telling you. Kimberly loves these. Kimberly, thank you. Kimberly, I hope you're going to give them a try. They are super easy to make. Super easy. So, now, here it. Well, we got to glue this end down just a little bit better, guys. We got to glue it down a little bit better. All right, so we are going to go just like that. You see it? Quick, simple, easy. Okay, they're adorable. Yes, they are. Okay, here's what we got going on. Now, this one, all I did was I took the strip of green and I wanted to make it kind of look like there's little leaves sticking out of it and just a little greenery coming down. Now, what you're gonna do is go to the blog and see what I did with the flowers I made today. I changed them up a little bit and I did something different. I told you I wasn't sure if I was putting a vase onto it or what I was doing. I finished that up. That's on the blog. Teresa, thank you, girl. Teresa says she loves it. Okay, now what we want to do is let's glue the bling. Now, I always tell you guys I get most of my bling from Hobby Lobby. Most of my bling comes from Hobby Lobby, but some of you guys sent me messages and I got on and I ordered bling, Totally Dazzled. So I ordered bling from Totally Dazzled. I got it all right here so I make sure I don't say the wrong place and all of that stuff. Totally Dazzled is where I got bling. Now the bling you can order, they have a variety, guys. They have tons of bling, right? So I got ones that are little pins, ones that are buttons. The bling from Hobby Lobby that I send you guys to all the time, they're just like buttons. So, hey, Kathy, thank you for joining me on YouTube, girl. That's so special that you guys are joining me on YouTube. So glad to catch you live. Yes! Listen, I don't know if anybody's on YouTube that's not on Facebook. We get messages and you guys say, I don't do Facebook, so can you get on Instagram? All this kind of stuff. So that's why I try to change it up a little bit. Okay, bam. Look, I put a little bling in the center of the flower. Now, you don't have to add bling, but I think a little bit of everything. We got a rustic look here. We've got the flowers, which by all means look a little rustic, and then a pop of bling. Now, the question is, this is all I did. I cut a piece of green cheesecloth. Now, guys, cheesecloth, you guys can color it any way you want. You can water down paint and dip it in a bowl of watered down paint. You can use the Rit dye if you want to. I like it with instant coffee. This is one I bought green. It is a table scarf in Hobby Lobby. They have table scarves. They have different colors and it's just, hey Angela, woohoo girl, thanks for joining me on YouTube. Okay, now all I did was take the piece of green cheesecloth, I folded it in half, and then I folded it in half again, but to make the ends not show and have my little edges like this for a leaf, I just put the end in the middle and then bam, it kind of looks like a little bow tie. And then all I did was I glued it to the back and you're gonna just stick it out wherever you want. So do you see how it just kind of looks like a little bit of foliage to it? So Jackie saw me on Facebook today. Yay, Jackie. Okay, so now we need to put a bling on this bigger one right here. So I'm just gonna put some glue on here and I'm going to shove this bling down here. I could have pinned this one on. This one was a pin, but to be a little quick. Totally Dazzled, awesome. Awesome bling, guys. Totally Dazzled has awesome bling. And if you spend a certain amount, it's free shipping. I think I wanna say you have to spend though over $100. I can't remember. I'm getting addicted to your show. You are so sweet. Okay, so look, this is what we got going on. Now, I'm not sure where I want the green, so I didn't glue this on yet. Oh my gosh, guys, are you seeing this? Look at the handle and then look at the flowers. Now, I need to sand this a little bit. I need it to show a little bit of the silver and a little bit of the brown under, but lo and behold, I left that over in the other room of the warehouse. So this is our YouTube channel, guys. This is where I try to do only my YouTube videos. Only I try. Let's see, how's the house painting coming, Jackie? Well, the house is almost done. They still have to do all the fencing and everything, but the house is almost done and it is stinking amazing. Now, I do think, I'm not sure, I'm still him and hawing over the blue ceiling for the porch. I'm still hemming and hawing over that. So, Teresa, thank you so much. Teresa says this is adorable. Teresa, this is stinking cute, is it not? All right, so look, this is what we got going on. I'm not sure, so I want them all right here. And I'm thinking, oh guys, I'm thinking just like this. And then I'm thinking this one right here, like that. Do you see it? Okay, let's glue them. Let's glue them and let's see what we got going on here. So this one's already stuck on here. Let's stick this one on. Let's get it on really, really good. So let's stick it all on. All right, so we've got this one all in place right here, okay? And then we're going to stick this one right here. So we need glue all on the back of this. Okay. I hope when I go to post this video, it's okay, because I don't know what happened there for a little bit, guys. I froze up. I don't know what happened. Okay, so let's see. Hey, Christine. Hey, Diana. Diana, thank you for watering, Diana. Okay, so then you've got this one right here. Are you seeing that? Guys, you see how it looks so rustic and farmhouse looking? And then, I don't know, I'm liking the little hanging greenery stuff. Some people like it, some people don't. I like it. I don't know why, but I do like it. And then we're gonna just go like this. So look, what we did is we incorporated, we did this a few days ago. Totally a little bit two different looks here. We did this one a few days ago. We did the flowers today, okay? And then I combined this can we used a few days ago with the flowers. I just want to show you how you can mix all the different crafts together. So totally two different looks here a little bit. So this one's Mod Podged with napkins, decoupage. So love it. That would be stunning to gift flowers in. Yes, it would. Wouldn't it? It would be nice for your husband to bring you a whole big bouquet of flowers in here, right? So look, now this handle's really cute for this one because it's bringing out that green on the cheesecloth, I feel like. So that's all. I wanted to really just come on. I wanted to say hello. I wanted to tell you guys thanks for following the channel on the YouTube channel for the Shabby Tree. Hey, Teresa, thank you. Hey, Jackie. I love the handle too. The handle's stinking cute. Isn't that Hobby Lobby? Handles, both handles are from Hobby Lobby. Napkins are from Home Goods. Can is recycled. Can's recycled. So guys, this is it. I just wanted to jump on. I wanted to tell you all to have a great evening. This one's stinking cute. I will sand it down. I'm going to post a picture of it in just a little bit. So let's see. Christine, you're so stinking sweet. Christine Fleischer. Girl, you PM me your address, Christine. Christine, thanks for joining me on YouTube. I have to write your name down real quick before I forget your last name. Okay, everybody, listen. Make sure you're following on YouTube. Subscribe, comment helps me out, all that kind of stuff. So Angela, have a great evening, everyone. Hey, Sherry, get some rest. I am heading home, guys. I gotta go home and see how far they got on the house, okay? I'll see you guys all tomorrow morning. Thanks for joining me, guys. See ya.